garden shop today, I've got a little bit of a challenge. This is an old Chinese juniper that belongs to a friend of mine. Approached me 5 years ago and asked me if I could help him to restore the tree, bring it back to health, and ultimately style it. So this is what we're going to start doing today. Now, the tree is strong, it's healthy. We've removed several branches that we really didn't need on the lower part of the tree, and so now I have to get to grips with the foliage that remains and begin to put some style into that and also get this trunk nicely clean. What I don't want to do is end up with a big, massive, heavy tree, so we're going to try and make something quite elegant from this material. Nice and balanced design, what we need to try and do is have the foliage and the trunk in proportion. As a general rule, the larger the trunk, the more bulky the trunk looks, the more aged the tree looks, and the more powerful it appears. So basically, in order to achieve that, I'm going to have to remove a couple of these branches. So here goes. Once I remove this, you'll see underneath the thickness of some of these branches that we've got, and also if I turn that, you can see that now we've got two primary branches here with all the foliage on. So this one we're going to take and we're going to move down to make the lower part of the tree, and then the apex is going to be built from these branches over here, and there's another one towards the back which we're going to use for a back branch to give the design some perspective. We've now finished pruning this tree back, we've cleaned up the deadwood, we've cleaned the bark, and so now it's time to begin looking at moving some of the branches. And as you can see here, they're not particularly massive, but because they're old, we want to protect these against breakage when we bend them, and the way that we do that is to use raffia. This is raffia that's been prepared for use. There's several long thick strands tied together, and it's soaked in water for about a quarter of an hour until it goes very slightly translucent. The way that we apply this is to lay it along the branch and then come round and then lay the longer part over its own end, and that locks it into position on the branch like this. So you can see that's nice and tight on there. And the point of using raffia is that when we bend the branch, the bark is inclined to split and the fibres tend to blow outwards and crack the branch. Because raffia is so strong, it stops that from happening, and it also cushions the bark against the pressure of the wire. As a raffia branch, it's important to keep it very, very tight. That's what helps to stop the branch breaking. Unfortunately, with raffia, when it's wet, it's very pliable and it's extremely strong. Once we've finished the branch, as you can see here, we then have the problem of actually tying that off. And the way that I like to do that is to divide the leading strand into two parts and then take one part that goes over the other part, and then we lay one along the branch. So now we're binding the end of the branch with just half of the original strand. And when we come to the end, we then take one backwards so that they're going in alternate directions this way, and then we can just tie that off easily. Okay, we've now finished raffia and preparing this branch, and you can see what I've done is gone over this with some black rubber tape that offers additional protection for the bark against the wire. I've wired it along the branch, and I've also wired these secondary branches to help me as I begin to move this big one. And the way that we move these large branches, the wire is really there for more of a measure of support than to hold it in place. So take this piece of copper wire, which is tucked under this strand of thicker wire here, and then we just take those two ends and hook that over, in this case a conveniently placed gin, and we just twist those together. Then we can take gin pliers, and while gently bending the branch, we can twist the wire, and that allows us to bend this branch in a very controlled manner without really any fear of breaking it at all. Sometimes with old junipers like this, the branches are very hard, so the best way to be able to bend a branch like this successfully is, as I've just done, to give it a little bit of a bend and a little pull and then leave it for half an hour, then come back and do some more, and progressively it'll move into the position that we want. The wiring on this tree, and so the work now is just to place the branches. Obviously you've seen this before, but in this case obviously I'm looking to compact the tree quite a bit and also to bring in the width of it to make it look much more dynamic. Finished placing the branches on this tree. The last stage that I like to do is just to trim out all the small shoots and untidy parts that are hanging down underneath the pads. This gives for a nice tidy clean finish, and once this work is done, this tree will be put into some warm shade for a few weeks until normal growth resumes, and then it'll go outside in the sunshine for the rest of the year, and then repotting will be done within probably a year's time.